I'm Neils Christensen with welcome to Kitco News. I'm here with Ian Ball, CEO of Abitibi Royalties, and Glenn Mullan, president of PDAC and chairman of Abitibi Royalties. We hear about negative sentiment in the marketplace, you know, but a prestigious mining company is ringing the Nasdaq. I mean, how does that feel to you?
Well, it's good to be invited down by the Nasdaq first to list on their international exchange and to come here and ring the bell. It's obviously, it's an honor for us to, you know, be here with a lot of great companies that have been preceded us.
So let's sort of wanted to jump in. I mean, a lot of news in the mining sector. I want to get your thoughts on the gold price. I mean, Glenn, maybe you can, you know, as chairman of PDAC, I mean, you have your finger on the pulse of the entire sector. You know, we're up 2% today. Equities are struggling. The last 5 days, worst sell-off in 2 years. Are we seeing a change in sentiment? Is this the spark to ignite the gold rally?
Well, it's an interesting dynamic because living in a very small gold mining town, I actually see the two extremes where producers are enjoying great prosperity and junior equities, junior mining companies are really struggling to raise financing for their exploration programs. So both of those are true right now. They're both extreme. It's really tough for junior companies to raise money, and it's a really good time to be a major producer.
Do you think that's going to change, though? I mean, you know, as gold prices go up, I mean, you know, we've broken that 200 barrier. We're at, last time I checked, near a 6-week high. Will more focus now, do you think, be on the junior sectors? They have the most potential. I mean, you know, it will Abitibi Royalties sort of reap the benefits if we see, you know, sort of a new rally in the gold market?
Well, obviously the gold price helps Abitibi as you generate more gold off of your royalty, your cash flow is going to go up. But even with a gold price environment that's been quite difficult, you've seen Abitibi share price up on the year. So, you know, if you can have that tailwind, great, but certainly for our own Pacific business, you know, a higher gold price isn't necessary to generate a return based on the organic growth that we have, but higher gold price is good for everybody.
Well, and you guys have been very active in acquisitions last few months. You're saying spent $2 million in royalties, and that's what we've been hearing is, you know, sort of these low prices value. Is that still the case? Like, how is there, even with the gold price going up, is there still value to be found?
Well, I think when you look at when you should be buying, it's very hard to predict where our price is going to turn. So I think our general philosophy is we think that when we want to be buyers in the bottom third of the gold range, we feel that we're there. And then whether you buy at the very bottom or you buy, you know, when it's off of its lows, I think it's still a good time to be looking to grow your business. You know, gold prices have been up for 2 days. So, you know,
true.
We're not going to say we're in a bull market, but we're also not in a bear market, but we do think we're at the bottom end of the price range. Mm-hmm.
We have seen some big mergers and acquisitions, you know. Do you think this is just the start? I mean, is this now the time to be sort of, you know, getting the juniors as there's consolidation in the marketplace?
Well, it's obviously better, I think, for an investor's perspective that these consolidations and transactions are happening at a low ebb in the cycle as compared to the past decade when most of them happened at the top end and then caused capitulation in the aftermath. So right now there are some really good opportunities driven by value mostly, and it's probably the beginning of an edge, I would think.
Well, I mean, so, you know, again, you spent $2 million in the last few months. You guys are actively buying back your shares. Are there other areas that are there deals that you're working on right now? I mean, do you want to make deals in this environment?
If that makes sense, you know, you have to evaluate what you already own. I think the industry has really suffered for not believing in its own assets. We always have this human psychology that, well, their assets better than ours, so we have to own it. And I think that's a wrong mentality in the mining sector. You know, believe in yourself, and I think, you know, we certainly believe in our assets, and we think that the growth that we're seeing at the new discoveries of Canadian Malartic, it's gonna be hard to match those. So that's why we've been buying back our shares. But if we can find something that presents, you know, exceptional value, well, then we have to evaluate it.
One of the things that you've said is you've said that the mining sector does need to consolidate. You know, like mining companies
should be.
Well, mining companies should be looking around their neighborhood and investing, you know, in projects that, you know, sort of are close to them that makes sense. Do you see more consolidation in the marketplace?
I just think that companies should be looking to acquire assets in areas that they're already operating. If you have a mine and it's built, your biggest fixed cost has already been incurred. So to bring another deposit online is an incremental cost. So if you're a major, I would be scouring around my existing mines for opportunities in the junior sector, which is quite depressed, versus having to go build a brand new mine. So there are opportunities, but I think you have a competitive advantage where you already operate. You know the government, you know the geology, you have a workforce, and I think that's where the focus should be.
That's really all the questions I have. I thank you very much for your time. Congratulations for this achievement with Nasdaq. I think it's an incredible event.